Let begin with the first question. Peter bought two identical tables and two identical chairs for $30. Two chairs cost as much as one table. What was the cost of one chair? First, let's identify the key information. $30 is the value for two tables and two chairs. The value for the two chairs is equal to one table. We can draw a diagram to indicate their relationship as shown on the left. As we can see, the value for the two chairs is equivalent to one table. We can make a swap. Now we can see $30 is also the value of three tables. In order to find the value of the two chairs, we need to find the value of one table. Let's focus on the tables first. $30 is the value of three tables, so for the value of one table would be $30 divided by 3, which equal to $10. So one table costs $10. Since two chairs cost as much as one table, and one table cost $10, therefore two chairs cost $10. To find out the cost of one chair, we simply divide $10 by 2. That equals to $5. So one chair costs $5. Let's do another problem. Jean brought thrice as many pens as pencils. Each pen cost $3 and each pencil cost $1. If she spent $50 altogether, how many pens and how many pencils did she buy? We can say $50 is the buy unknown sets of pens and pencil. Each set comprises of 3 pens and 1 pencil. First, we need to find out how much is the total cost of a set which comprises of 3 pens and 1 pencil. Since each set has 3 pens, we multiply $3 by 3, which give us $9. Then we add $1, which is the cost of a pencil, to it. That give us $10. So we know each set costs $10. The next step is to find out how many sets are there. Since we know she spent total of $50, so for $10, it would be $50 divided by $10, which is 5. So there are 5 sets. So to find out how many set of pens, we simply do the multiplication. 5 multiplied by 3 equal to 15. That means there are 15 pens. As for the pencil, each set only has a pencil, so the total number of pencil is 5. Here come question 3. 5 identical books or 15 identical files can be packed into a box. How many of such files can be placed together with 3 such books into the box? Firstly, we know that the volume of 15 files is equal to 5 books. So when there are 3 books in the box, it has a space of 2 books. We can simply do it by 5 minus 3. Now we need to know how many files can be fixed into the space of 1 book. That would be 15 divided by 5. That is 3 files. So since there is an empty space for 2 books, to know how many files can be placed inside, we simply multiply 2 by 3, which is 6. So 6 files can be placed into the box together with 3 books. Let's look into another problem. 6 identical wallets and 2 identical belt cost $50. 2 wallets cost as much as 1 belt. What is the cost of 1 wallet? First, we draw a diagram as shown below. We know that 1 belt cost as much as 2 wallets. So we substitute the belt for wallets. We have 4 more wallets. We have a total of 10 wallets for the cost of $50. So each wallet would be $50 divided by 10 wallets, and that is $5. So the cost of the wallet is $5. Let's do a final problem. 4 pens and 7 exercise books cost $43. 4 pens and 3 exercise books cost $23. Find the cost of each exercise book. We can draw a bar diagram as shown on the left. From the bar diagram, we can detect there is a difference of 4 exercise books. Let's find the difference. $43 minus $23 equal $20. So the cost of each exercise book would be $20 divided by 4, which equal to $5. That is all for now. Do visit our site for educational resources and information. Please subscribe our channel for update. Thank you for watching.